Does time move only when we observe it, or does it continue to flow regardless of our existence? There are many questions, but are there any answers? Does time have a beginning? The Big Bang Theory proposes that the universe began approximately 13.8 billion years ago in a state of high density and high temperature. According to this theory, the Big Bang is the beginning of both time and space. At the start of the explosion, all matter and energy, concentrated in a very small and dense point, began to expand. And as a result of this expansion, the universe formed. This theory is based on Einstein's theory of general relativity. The theory of general relativity shows that time and space are not separate from each other, but are interconnected. Therefore, according to this theory, neither time nor space existed before the Big Bang, because they emerged not as a kind of void, but as part of the structure of the universe. Quantum mechanics and cosmology offer some different approaches at this point. For example, some theories suggest that before the Big Bang, different quantum phenomena could have made the concept of time possible. However, since these theories have not yet been fully proven, the Big Bang is widely accepted as the starting point. Thus, the Big Bang is considered not only the beginning of matter and energy in the universe, but also the beginning of time and space. The concept of time can be broadly explained from both physical and philosophical aspects. Physically, time is an indicator that ensures events in the universe occur in a specific sequence. In the past, Newton proposed that time was absolute, meaning a fixed concept flowing at the same speed everywhere. But with Albert Einstein's theory of relativity, this concept changed. Time is relative and variable. It can flow at different speeds depending on the speed and mass of events. For example, large masses, for example planets, cause time to flow slower in their proximity. Philosophically, the essence of time is seen as a more subjective concept. People experience time by transitioning between past, present, and future. Time also enables the formation of our memory, memories, and experiences. It helps humans plan their lives, learn, and gain lessons from their experiences. Some scientists suggest that in quantum physics, time does not physically exist and may only be a product of human consciousness. In terms of quantum mechanics, time is sometimes understood merely as a concept expressing the relationship between events. There are numerous approaches to the subject of time in both science and philosophy. This shows that time remains an incompletely understood and interesting field of research. Does time move at the same speed for everyone? It has been scientifically proven that time does not progress at the same speed for everyone. According to Albert Einstein's theory of relativity, time is a relative concept and can flow at different speeds for people moving at different speeds or under different gravitational influences. This phenomenon is called time dilation and mainly depends on two factors, speed and gravitational force. Time dilation due to speed. According to Einstein's special theory of relativity, the faster an object moves, the slower it experiences time. For example, for an astronaut moving at high speed in space, time will pass slower compared to a person remaining on Earth. This phenomenon is called Lorentz transformation, and it shows that as speed increases, time passes slower. Time dilation due to gravitational force. The general theory of relativity shows that time passes slower near massive objects. Example, planets or black holes. The reason is that large masses curve space-time and time dilates in accordance with this curvature. For example, time passes slower for a person on the surface of the Earth compared to a person in the emptiness of space. These effects have also been proven through scientific experiments. Clocks in fast-moving objects like GPS satellites operate differently compared to clocks on the Earth's surface. These relative time dilations are accounted for GPS systems to function accurately. Therefore, time is not constant for everyone and progresses at different speeds under different conditions. Is it possible to stop time? Completely stopping time is not possible, according to current physical knowledge. Albert Einstein's theory of relativity shows that the speed of time depends on the object's motion speed and the space-time region it occupies. Theoretically, if an object moves close to the speed of light, time slows down significantly for that object. Reaching the speed of light would mean time completely stops, because in this case, time would not pass for that object. However, since no object is massless, it cannot reach the speed of light, which shows that completely stopping time is impossible. The strong gravitational field of black holes can also produce effects close to stopping time. The clock of an object approaching the event horizon of a black hole appears stopped to a distant observer. However, this effect only appears that way to the observer. For the object itself, time continues to progress. Some quantum physics theories explain the nature of time differently and suggest that the flow of time might take different forms at microscopic scales. However, this is still only at the theoretical level and not fully proven. Based on current scientific understanding, completely stopping time is not possible. What would happen if time didn't exist?
A situation without time would lead us to imagine a very different world from physical, philosophical, and human experience perspectives. Physically, the absence of time would mean events in the universe could not occur. Time ensures the sequence and variability of events. For example, processes like the motion of matter, the birth and death of stars, chemical reactions, and the development of life would not be possible without time. Without the flow of time, cause and effect relationships would also disappear, and everything in the universe would remain unchanged and static. Philosophically, the absence of time would mean the disappearance of concepts like memories, plans, and progress, which are fundamental elements of human experience. People build their lives based on past experiences, make plans for the future, and live meaningful lives through these processes. In a world without time, all experiences could be disconnected, unchanging, and meaningless, because concepts like past, present, and future would not exist. According to quantum physics, time also plays an important role in some fundamental processes. For example, the behavior of subatomic particles and changes in quantum states are related to time. Without time, such changes occurring and energy flow continuing would be difficult. Generally, the absence of time means the absence of motion and change. For this reason, time is an essential foundation for the existence of everything in the universe. If this concept didn't exist, we wouldn't be able to talk about time today. After all, we couldn't discuss a matter unknown to us. In philosophy, time is the perception by humans of the sequence of occurring events. These changes justify the direction of time. The existence of time has been described in various ways by great philosophers like Plato, Aristotle, Augustine, Leibniz, and Kant. In reality, during the state we experience as dreaming, it lasts only a few minutes or even a few seconds. Under different conditions, people perceiving the same time interval as longer or shorter is also an example of this. For instance, for a person waiting for their brother to come out of surgery, 1 hour might feel as long as several hours. But the same person, while doing work they greatly enjoy, might not even notice how an hour passed. The truth, scientifically revealed by the general theory of relativity, is this: The speed of time changes depending on an object's speed and its distance from the gravitational center. As speed increases, time shortens, contracts, working heavier, slower, as if approaching a stopping point. This can be explained with the twin paradox. According to this example, if one twin brother stays on Earth and the other travels to space at a speed close to the speed of light, the person who went to space will see their twin brother older than themselves upon returning. The reason is that time passes slower for the brother traveling in space. Time being relative does not mean the clock slows down or speeds up. It means that the entire material system, down to subatomic particles, operates at different speeds. In an environment where time is shortened, heartbeats in the human body, cell division, and brain activity work more slowly. In this case, the person continues their daily life without even noticing the slowing of time. Is time a reality that exists independently of the human mind? The moment we begin to think about time, the first concept we should consider is change. Changes occurring between events and within events themselves constitute the core part of our initial perception of time's existence. Throughout the history of philosophy, this concept has been used alongside terms like occurrence, flow, or motion. In ancient Greek philosophy, one of the ontological discussions, starting with Parmenides, was aimed at understanding the concepts of time and change. On the other hand, in the modern era, there are various approaches regarding the relationship between time and change. For example, Platonism, opposing the reductionist approach that evaluates time alongside change, claims that time is possible even without change. Although in modern times this topic has been reopened for discussion with Sidney Shoemaker's work, Time Without Change, the idea that there is a fundamental connection between time and change is based on a tradition originating from Heraclitus and Aristotle. While Heraclitus emphasized that everything is in constant motion, some commentators have boldly equated time with motion. Aristotle systematized the concept of time through the term moment. He described the measure of time as motion occurring between two moments, and explained time as a measure determined based on the concepts of before and after in relation to motion. This approach shows that time is tied to moving entities and is formed through their before and after relationships with each other. So, how does change occur? Can change happen from the future to the present, or from the present to the past? Or is it possible to think from the present to the future? For some philosophers, the states of past, present, and future time do not coincide. If an event occurred in the past, it no longer exists in the present and future. Similarly, if an event is happening in the present, it does not exist in the past or the future. If it will happen in the future, it does not exist now or in the past.
This idea seems intuitively logical. No event can exist simultaneously in the past, present, and future. If this idea is true, then the idea that, for time to exist, change must also exist, may seem logical. There are various scientific and philosophical opinions about time. According to science, time is one of the fundamental dimensions of the universe. In philosophy, its reality, speed, and relative perception are discussed. In our daily lives, time sometimes feels like it passes quickly, sometimes slowly. In fact, even if we cannot stop or control it, how we use it is our own choice. Thank you for watching. If we're lucky, we'll see you in other videos.